about the other days, educate people and teach them about the end of the world. And we have a saying at the Columbus School they have here at SeaWorld as well, that is, touch the heart and teach the mind. Touch the heart and teach the mind. No matter whether you're, what you do in life, especially in the animal world, if you can't touch your heart and teach your mind, why we have the beautiful SeaWorlds, the beautiful Columbus School, the beautiful West Gardens, then we're not doing our job. And that's what these animals are here for. They are ambassadors to their cousins in the wild. A lot of people know me as a fun person. You see that goofy thing up in that video we just saw, that I am a fun person. But there is that 1% of Jack Hanna that had a serious side. So let me take 3 minutes, if I could, and just be serious about something that was really not concerning me anymore, because right is right and wrong is wrong. I want to mention they quote this film that you've been seeing, let's put it that way, this last year or so, The Gilded SeaWorld. Let me tell you folks something. You know, I do so much for SeaWorld, it's not even monetarily involved. Yes, I do certain things wrong. Yes, I do. I don't do it for that reason. A lot of you love SeaWorld, you're here, and that's what SeaWorld wants to see in your family. You're the SeaWorld family. Without you folks, let me tell you something. Without this park, these whales, people would not know anything about them, number one. Number two, in 1973, I was raised on a farm in Tennessee, everyone. I cleaned cages for veterinary for 6 years, when I was 16 years old. I knew I loved animals. I told myself at 16 kids that I wanted to be a zookeeper. But then I grow up, I take my little girl to Orlando, they have a little zoo there with 4 employees. I saw Orlando from the Sanford Zoo. Now it's the Central Florida Zoo. I heard about SeaWorld opening in 1973. So what I do, I take my little 2 little girls, one wasn't born yet, to SeaWorld. I saw those whales for the first time. Now me being from Tennessee, everybody, all I'd ever seen is a carp, a bass, and maybe a guppy or something. Never ever dreaming of seeing a killer whale, or even a whale or a diesel, or a dolphin, or a sea turtle. So what did I just say? Touch the heart and teach the mind. That's what SeaWorld's done. Also, what some of the things in that documentary with some of those footage from 25, 30 years old? Yes, certain things were done back then. This is a SeaWorld of today. Yes, my daughter was used for research at St. Jude Hospital. As a result of her research, she now has brain tumors. She's 39 years old, had a last out last year. But you know something? That was done, that protocol was done in 1977, not today. The Columbus Zoo did things, I'm sure a lot of zoo discussions, I'm sure a lot of doctors did, I'm sure a lot of people did a lot of things. But this is today, SeaWorld. What's going on out here with these folks out front and some out there today, I want to mention everything, give them credit. You gotta understand what these folks do here, buddy. They love these animals, these trainers, these keepers. These guys can have jobs on the table, anywhere else in the world. And when you see this happening, it hurts me deeply. It really does. But Jack Hanna would not be on this stage or anything with this part if I thought one item in that quote show that you saw was true. When you take ex-employees, everyone, you always should question that. And not only that, I'll admit this. Dawn's mother, who lost her life at SeaWorld, was a very dear friend of mine. I had to do her funeral at SeaWorld. Dawn's mother last weekend, this was last weekend, I was at SeaWorld doing shows for 9,000 people, 4 shows at their theater there. Who sat next to my wife for all those shows? Dawn's mother, who loves SeaWorld. That should tell you anything and everything about what you saw on TV. When the mother of a child who loses her life to do something she believed in, that's the epitome of all of our lives. But she gave her life because she loved the whales and she loved SeaWorld. And that's how I want SeaWorld to be known as. A park, a place that teaches us about the world's most magnificent animals. Plus, if you took the 221 zoos and did this, 221 zoos in this country, put us all together and talk about the rehab and release animals in the wild, SeaWorld would outnumber us 10 to 1. All the 221 zoos together, the millions of dollars these parks have spent in the last 40 years, millions, to release animals so they can enjoy nature. Can we have a round of applause for Park Tigers? Dan Decker is the CEO of this park. I don't care, I've never done this before, so Dan's in a bit. But this man has lived through a lot this last year. This man,